Hello Airsoft World! Today we are reviewing the Novrich SSG-24. The package includes the hardshell case, the sniper rifle Novrich SSG-24, one magazine, Novrich BBs in this metal can, some patches, Allen keys, barrel cleaning rod, and a magazine adapter. I really don't know how to start, what to show you or what to say, I just want to look at it and shoot with it. From the one side, I listen a lot of bad things about this rifle and so much hate, but from the other side, I listen the best. So, after having it on my hands for a long time, I can have my own view about this rifle. Let's get started. At the beginning, I have to mention that it looks like a modified Mod 24 base rifle upgrading by Novrich. Generally, the rifle is made of full CNC aluminum, metal and high quality plastic parts. The length is 109.5cm to 115.5cm and weighs 2.6 kilos. Let's take all the parts one by one. The SSG-24 stock length of 75cm is made from glass fiber reinforced polymer plastic, just like the stock from the real M24 as the manufacturer supports. It has 7mm thickness material, the stock is adjustable, you can fit it to the length of your arms, there is rubber butt pad where you can find the Novrich logo and there is a CNC aluminum screw to adjust it and lock in place. Every single part of the assembly is CNC machined to ensure that, and yes, there is no wobbling, no unwanted sounds, and any idea of cheap-made material. The twisted fluted outer barrel is a CNC machine, 4.5mm aluminum, thick, really tough, 3cm outer diameter fat all the way down. The CNC machined end cap has an O-ring inside to stabilize the inner barrel. Unscrew the end cap counterclockwise and screw it clockwise. The receiver is made of metal and has an individual Novrich SSG-24 serial number. On the top we have a CNC aluminum extended rail, it is a little bit longer than usually, it has a cutout and 4 steel screws to keep it in place, metal trigger and trigger guard. There is one sling attachment point at the back and two in the front. One of them is actually a screw to hold the barrel and there are two extra screws. Until now, all these details show us the build to reinforce from Novrich. The inner barrel is a 47.5cm length, 6.01mm diameter, aluminum barrel is hard oxidized, is stabilized additionally through a barrel spacer in the middle of the outer barrel and an O-ring as we already mentioned in the end cap of the outer barrel. The hop-up adjustment needs no tools, is on the left side of the rifle, I really like this click position adjustment, it's hard to move, I also like that because you don't have to adjust it again and again after some shots. Inside the adjustment is on both sides of the chamber, so it avoids side hop effects. The hop-up is aluminum CNC machine, as also the hop-up arm, and it can hop 0.43g BB max, at least at this SSG. Time to test the air seal. Cock the rifle, close the inner barrel with your finger and pull the trigger. You see that the piston will stop before hitting the cylinder head, due to the perfect air seal. The cylinder is black oxidized after more than 1000 shots, you can see that it is already deteriorated, but I can say that the bolt is enough smooth. The spring guard is made of polished stainless steel and it has no bearings. The SSG-24 comes with a metal housing, 2 stages, 90 degree trigger, you can see that it doesn't tilt up, it just moves back. The first stage is adjustable, rotating this screw over here, lightweight trigger travel, pull the trigger back until you can feel the resistance. Where the second stage starts, the trigger weight increases and it's very, very short. The spring guide stopper, the trigger and the piston sear are made of hardened double heat threaded steel, so all this setup can easily handle springs up to M190 due to the manufacturer. This is a double stack magazine made of plastic, it weighs 45g and holds 28 BBs. A nice feature is that it is transparent, so you can check how many BBs you have left in your mag. Again, there is no wobbling, clicks in place perfectly and the mag moves out when you push the magazine release button. The magwell is made of plastic. The dimensions of the magazine is 10cm length, 4.5cm height, so it is not fit on a pistol magazine pouch. M4 magazine pouch is big enough for that, so I think the best is the grenade pouch. This is a benefit buying this rifle because it comes in a nice plastic hard shell case, wide 25 cm, length 125 cm, height 5 and 5 cm, locking 4 slide points, and inside of it there is a foam to keep your rifle safe. Let's quick talk about the aftermarket accessories. I really like the fact that Novorizh does not sit back and relax, and he's always trying to offer more and more stuffs and accessories to his market. There's already an M40A3 body, a left-hand conversion kit, FPS adjuster rings, and as we read, shorter outer and inner barrel, silencer, floated cylinder, mag pouches and full rail will be released in the near future. Furthermore, Novorizh gives you detailed videos on how to change all his aftermarket accessories. Thumbs up for that. Why to buy it? At first I was thinking, okay, how much good it can be? I tested it, I saw it many times, you like it or not, it is very good. The consistency on every shot is great, it is good made, solid, if you fall down it will not break, you feel like you have a gun with you and not a toy airsoft rifle, and it is not so heavy as I was expecting to be. It is already fully upgraded, out of box, you don't need to do nothing, just to go to the field, adjust the hop up and shoot people in the face. Okay, try not to shoot people in the face. Plus there is a variety on aftermarket accessories to customize it as you like. In my opinion, the only negative on the rifle is that maybe I wanted it to be a little bit more silent. And of course the taxes and all this extra money you have to pay to import it into Europe, almost doubling the total amount. Last but not least, I want to mention that it is normal this new cam rifle to have some little problems, like the first 100 magazines misfit problem or with the bolt safety problem, but Novorizh dealt with it really fast. I really admire that he keeps reading the feedbacks on Facebook groups and he answers to everybody, he's trying to get improved, discuss any problem you may have, he also makes detailed videos to help you. That's so professional from his side. Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. Don't forget to leave a like, it's really helped me and cost you nothing. Comment your opinion about this rifle, I really want to hear that. And of course subscribe to my channel to support me. Click to watch other videos or like my Facebook page, link is in the video description to keep in touch. See you on the fields.